Start with the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most gracious. Dear students of class first year, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome you in Pakistan International School Taif Virtual Learning System. Hope you all are well and doing hard with your studies. And may God bless you and success you in your examinations. Dear students, today we have English lecture number 21, and this is for grade first year. And today we have unit 5, the lighter side. The topic is the lighter side of unit 5, and reading selection 5.1, Fly Away. This is narrative. Dear students, fly away. In the last lecture, we completed our unit 4. And last lecture, we completed reading selection 4.3, be the best of whatever you are. So today we are going to start the unit 5, the lighter side, and we have the topic of reading selection 5.1, Fly Away, page number 108 to 114, and I'm your teacher, Sarfaraz Nadeem. Pre-reading about Fly Away, dear students. Here we have the focusing on the title. Can you guess what this narrative is all about? Read the extract to check if your guess was right. For the guessing, if you will guess what the narrative is about, and then you have to read the lesson, and then you will get your answer. So let's start the reading. Here we have just the page preview as well, as you can see over here, and it is about the reading selection 5.1, Fly Away. Ralph Helfer is the writer of unit 5, and you can see in the picture flies as well. So let's see what's wrong with them. I need 5,000 trained flies. Can you do it? Yes or no? The voice at the other end of the phone was insistent. Well, of course you can't, Helfer. Nobody can. Look, I told the director I would make a couple of calls. So now I have. The answer is obviously no. Eka, do it. I said, fitting my sentence neatly in between my caller's constant job. But I'll need a couple of days. The voice on the phone was silent a moment, then, you're kidding. No, really, 2 days and I'll be ready. What do they have to do? There is the artificial dead looking thing lying on the ground in the forest. The director wants thousands of flies to be crawling on it without flying away. So dear student, this is page number 108. And you can see the flies in the picture. And this was the discussion about the director. So let's think, this is an amazing story about all the skill of Ralph Helfer. And he's a well-known animal trainer. And he says that once he received a call that a film director needed 5,000 trained flies, he replied that he could provide the flies within 2 days. He asked the caller that what the flies were needed for. He was told that there would be a dead thing lying on the ground. The flies would crawl on it without flying away. Then they would fly away when told. This task was very difficult. Okay, I said, consider it done. Now, wait. Then he wants them all to fly away on command, but not before. Okay, no problem. I said, 2 days. Wait. Did you hear what they said? They can't leave until he says, okay, how are you going to keep them there? Let alone have them fly away when he wants them to. I'll stick each of their 20,000 legs in glue. Look, don't worry, call me later and I'll give you the figure. Bye. Sometimes affection training was not the only answer. One could not pet a fly or earn its respect. I knew I would have to resort to the flaws of nature for the answer to this one. I would had the opportunity to work with various insects in the past, but 5,000, I hoped I hadn't bitten more than I could chew. I went to work first converting an old box in which we'd been keeping crickets. We raised them to feed to the tuntles. The box was about 3 feet high by 2 feet square. Patching up a few holes, I scrubbed clean, fixed a crooked door and set it inside the snake room. The next day, I visited a good friend of mine, Professor Jonathan Ziller, an entomologist and researcher. His work area consists of 20 to 30 lab type cages made of fine mesh wire. Each contained a different species of insect. Over a cup of coffee, I told him of my needs. We walked over to a cage that was being heated by a special infrared lamp. Inside, I could see massive swarms of maggots, fly larvae, ready to be hatched into their next stage. As I stood there, the professor calculated the exact time when they would become flies. As his watch struck the birthing time, thousands of flies left their maggot bodies and were suddenly airborne, buzzing about the cage. We both agreed that these flies, an unusually large type that resembled the housefly, would be perfect. An added plus was the fact that they were all hybrid, incapable of breeding. Hence, in releasing them, I would not be running the risk of upsetting the natural balance of the environment. The professor gave me a batch of fly larvae, which calculated would hatch on the morning of the shoot, along with a vial of a special harmless tranquilizer in a gas capsule. The gas would be released when the tip of the cigarette-sized plastic tube was broken. With the vial set inside the fly box, all the flies could be put to sleep within seconds. Once the gas had dissipated, in a matter of moment, the flies would awaken. The tranquilizer was, of course, harmless to people. A handshake later, I was off, gently carrying my brood with me. On the morning of the shoot, all the flies hatched right on schedule. I loaded up and headed for the studio location. When I arrived, I was greeted by a crew of disbelievers with tongue in check. Attitudes, bets, and jokes were being made in every direction, all in good natured fun. The director, a big friendly sort, came over to me with a suspicious look in his eyes. Is it true? What? That you can put 5,000 flies on something and they all crawl around, but you can guarantee they won't fly right off? It's true. Then when I tell you to let them go, they'll all fly away immediately? Give or take a few? A few what? Flies that won't fly away. If you pull this off, I'll double your fee, he said in disbelief. Ready whenever you are, I said, and headed for my fly house. The camera was set. The dead thing turned out to be a special effects monster baby that had supposedly died a while back and was now to be swarming with flies. Somebody was to walk by and the flies would then to have to fly away. Everything was ready. The special assistant director yelled for the fly man, one of my trainers, and I carried the fly house over and set it near the camera. The loud buzzing of an enormous number of flies was obvious. Sheets of heavy paper prevented anyone from seeing into the box. Now, Ralph, I'll roll the camera. Whenever you say, okay, I ask the director, sure, but everything has to be ready. I have only got 10,042 flies, just enough for two shots. His look told me he wasn't sure whether I was putting him or not. 10,042, really? He mumbled and walked over to the camera. With everything set, I opened the small door of the fly house, hiding the gas capsule in the palm of my hand and reaching inside. I broke it open, closed the door, and waited for 15 seconds. To every day's amazement, the buzzing stopped. Next, I opened the door and scooped out three or four handful of flies. I shook them out as one would when counting a pound of peanuts, putting the little sleeping flies all over the body. I began to dramatically count the last few. 5,020, 5,021, 5,022, that makes it half. I told everyone to hold still, then I gave the flies a verbal cue. Okay, guys, Jack, Bill, Mary, come on up and at. Slowly, the flies started to awaken, then move around. In a few moments, the whole mass of them was swarming all over the thing, but they were still too drowsy to fly, as my professor friend had told me there would be. Okay, roll, yelled the director. The camera rolled on the fly swarm, and I shot a look at the crew. They appeared to be in shock. Then, having gotten enough footage, he directly shouted, okay, Rolf, now, my great moment. Okay, group, I said to the flies, get ready on the count of three. All of you take off. The crew, absolutely bug-eyed, forgive the pun, was hypnotized. One, I counted, they looked from the flies to me. Two, three, I yelled, clapping my hands and stamping my foot on the same time. 5,021 flies flew away, up, around, and round. The camera hummed until the director, rousing himself from the maze state, said, cut. The entire queue was silent for a moment, and then they burst into applause and delighted laughter. You did it. You really did it, said the director, slapping me heartily on the back. I'm not even going to ask you now how. I don't even want to know, but if I ever need to train anything, you are the man I'll call. Straight faced, I said, well, actually, I've recently trained 432 flies to form a chorus line on my arm, and one cue, they all kick a leg at the same time. The director poker faced, looked straight at me. Which one? He asked. Which one? What? Which leg? The left one, of course. We all broke up laughing and headed home. Now, dear students, this was the story about this person who trained flies, and director was required to do. All the spectators were amazed to see this. The director came here and told after that he really did a wonderful job. He appreciated him by patting him on his back. About the author, dear students, Ralph Alpher from 1937 is one of the leading animal trainers in the world. He has persuaded animals to do what Hollywood directors wanted them to do it more than 5,000 movies and television programs. In this book, The Beauty of the Best, Alpher explains that his work as a stuntman and wild animal trainer has led to his being clawed by lions, attacked by bears, bitten by poisonous snakes, and nearly suffocated by pythons. Alpher and his trained animal have won 18 PETSAY awards for the best animal performance on the screen. He is the founder of Marine World Africa, USA. So, dear students, this was the story. that fly away means he said fly away means fly and go away. He trained, helped visited his friend Professor Jonathan, who helped him a lot. So this was the story. Hope you understood. Have a question and answers. So look over here. Here we have, dear students, on page number 113 and 114, we have few vocabulary of about the words and then study questions. I think it's quite easy for you to answer these questions after reading this. Like it is, what was Helfer asked to do? Very easy. Mr. Helfer was asked to provide 5,000 flies, and the flies were to be used on an artificial dead-looking thing. The flies were to crawl on it. They were required to fly away only when told to do so. So like other questions, like interpreting, extending, and language studies also about the adjective clauses. And we already completed our phrases and clauses. Today we have student translation. As you are well aware, especially the Pakistani students, that we have a topic over here about the translation. You are supposed to translate the Urdu passage into English, and there is a choice in this question in English paper, dear students. Choice is about the paragraph. Those who are non-Pakistanis, they will definitely attempt a paragraph, but the Pakistani students, they have a choice that if they want to do paragraph, either the or the translation. So that's why we have already completed about the paragraph. So today we will just have a look about few things about the translation. So have a look over here about the translation. Dear students, first of all, for the translation, you have to grip on over your tenses. As you know that we have basically the three tenses, present, past, and future. Then each tense contains four kinds of the present tense, four of past and four of future. It means total we have 12. So here in this table you can see the 12 verb tenses. Here simple past and simple present and simple future. I studied is the second form of verb, and it's used in past tense, and I study is in present tense, first form used in present tense, and I will study is the future. Continuous, I was studying, is a continuous tense. Was studying means past continue. I am studying means present continue. I will be studying is a future continuous. Perfect, I had studied, is a perfect, like past perfect, because we are using had over here. And I have studied is a present perfect. But in past perfect and present perfect, we both use the third form of the verb. I will have studies also the future perfect. Then we have the issue of past perfect continuous. I had been studying English, and present perfect continuous. I have been studying English, and future perfect continuous. I will have been studying English. So for translation, dear students, you must have a grip on tenses. You must go through from the tenses. You must know well known about the tenses. Here we have again another table, dear students. Here you can see the tenses are here: present simple, present continuous, present perfect continuous. Then affirmative sentence like I have a car, you are playing football now. Negative, I don't have a car, you are not playing. Interrogative, do I have? Interrogative means question. So here we have given three types of the sentence like affirmative, negative, interrogative. And especially Pakistani students, you are supposed to be very familiar. You have to be, because we have a Urdu passage for translation. So if you will know very well about the tenses, then it will be easy for you to translate the Urdu. Because if you will, translation will be very good. You will get good numbers, means a package of numbers. And in paragraph, definitely everything is has been checked, like your comma, your punctuation, for example, tenses and spellings, everything. Here we have tenses, dear students. A present indefinite tense, the formation like I, we, you, they, subject plus first form of verb like I write, object, letter. Wo meri baat sunti hai, she listens to me. Wo cricket khelta hai, he plays cricket. Wo maidan mein bhagta, he runs in the ground. So this is kind of present indefinite tense. He, she, it, first form,
as SES with the third person singular and object unit. So dear students, like all are here, you can see the Urdu sentences as well as English. Here we have past indefinite. This is present indefinite, this is past indefinite. Main kal school gaya. I went to school yesterday. वो मुझे ट्रेन में मिले. आई दे मेट मी इन द ट्रेन. वो आपसे बात करना चाहती थी. शी वांटेड टू टॉक टू यू. सो दीज आर द पास्ट इंडेफिनिट टेंस. नाउ यू हैव टू चेंज इनटू द उर्दू सेंटेंसेस इनटू इंग्लिश. सो देन यू मस्ट नो द वेयर वी हैव यूज फर्स्ट फॉर्म, सेकंड फॉर्म, एंड हाउ टू आइडेंटिफाई दिस इज विच टेंस. नाउ इन उर्दू डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट लाइक यू कैन सी इन द रेड, लाइक मैं कल स्कूल गया. So, gaya is a verb in the last, but in the English sentence, it comes after the subject, like went. Gaya went, mile, met, and baat karna thi, wanted. So, this is the, to identify the, isme se pata chalega ki which tense is this. Now, here, dear students, again, we have another page and all English tenses examples. Now, here, what we have to do, we have many Urdu sentences and their translation. Like, main ek umda camera rakhta hun. I have a fine camera. Hamare paas ek keemati ghadi hai. We have a precious watch. Iske paas ek chaku hai. He has a knife. So, like this, we have sentences. So, might be we don't have such sentences in our English paper, but we have a group of sentences, like a paragraph. A paragraph will be there in English paper and you have to translate it. So how to translate? We have these questions and answers, like how we have the Urdu sentences, how we have the English, and what are the English of the difficult words. Now here, dear students, a passage has been given in Urdu and then it is translated into English. Like first one, एक कंजूस था, एक दफा उसका बटवा गुम हो गया, बटवे में 100 रुपए थे. लाइक दिस, देयर वाज अ माइजर, वंस ही लॉस्ट हिज पर्स, देयर वर 100 रुपीस इन द पर्स. ही अनाउंस्ड, आई शैल गिव द 10 रुपीस टू हिम हु फाइंड्स एंड ब्रिंग्स द पर्स टू मी. वन डे अ फार्मर केम टू हिम विद हिज पर्स. द माइजर सर्च्ड आउट द पर्स, देयर वर एग्जैक्ट 100 रुपीस इन इट. व्हेन द फार्मर डिमांडेड हिज रिवार्ड, द माइजर सेड, there were 110 rupees in my purse. Now there are only 100. You have already taken 10 rupees. So like this is the translated page and we have Urdu passage as well. So like this passage, like this Urdu passage, there will be an exam. But exam mein isi tarah ka ek passage aayega, exam mein Urdu mein, and you have to translate into English like this. So like this 6 number passage is your homework. बेटा ये होमवर्क है. अनारकली लाहौर का मसरूफ तरीन बाजार है. ये हमेशा लोगों से भरा रहता है. दुकानें रात गए तक खुली रहती हैं. आप यहाँ तकरीबन हर किस्म की चीजें खरीद सकते हैं. कुछ लोग यहाँ से शिया खरीदने आते हैं, लेकिन बहुत से लोग सिर्फ शेर व तफरी के लिए आते हैं. अनारकली में बहुत सी फेरे वाले भी होते हैं. वो बटन, फीते, सोइयां, क्लब और इस किस्म की दूसरी अशिया बेचते हैं. कुछ जेब तराश भी अनारकली में आते हैं. अगर आप अनारकली जाएं तो उन जेब तराशों से होशियार रहें. सो नाउ यू हैव टू ट्रांसलेट दिस पैसेज into English, and this is your homework, dear students. Yes, this is your homework, and you have to send me after the completing of this passage, after the translating of the passage to me. I'll definitely check it and then we'll let you know how many students are able to make the no mistake, no any and they can do very well. So the second passage, this number 6 passage, is your homework. I'll check it. Number 5 is in Urdu and there is also English translation, but number 6 passage of Urdu is your homework. Please translate it into English. So dear students, this is all about today's lecture. We learned the 5.1 reading selection, fly away, and then we become familiar with translation and how to translate the sentences and even how to translate to the passage. So you must know about the tenses. Tenses are very important in English, and then it is very easy for you to learn, and then it will be quite easy for you to translate the Urdu sentences into English. So if you have any query, dear students, any problem, you can ask me on Zoom. I'm available over there. And till that, dear students, thank you. Allah Hafiz.